guest. It's me, Sean D. Ross. I'm the writer, producer, and director of the Jaclyn Hyde Project. You're now watching the behind the scenes into what it took to make this audio project a reality. Come on.
You're making fun of me.
His girl is a
gun. Oh,
boy's a liar, the boy's a liar.
Oh yeah,
he doesn't see ya.
Cause for the first time in forever, there'll be music, there'll be light. For the first time in forever.
Alright, so update. We actually checked out the wrong studio. So that's always nice. And Arturo's here. Yeah, so we are in the sound image suite and not the recording studio that I thought I'd checked out. So I'm just running a rehearsal with my two main actors for scene two, Arturo and Bella. Yeah, so hopefully this, I'm sure everything will go well, even though we didn't get the studio.
What an interesting person.
Hungry. I haven't eaten anything.
I have a salad. Do you want it?
Salad? Later, maybe.
How are we feeling, guys?
Feeling good.
I'm feeling good. Yeah.
Warden.
Feeling good. Understandable. I agree.
All right, it's Sean Ross, screenwriter, director, and editor. How do you feel about this project? We're working with Alex, Bella. I may have forgotten your name.
Jack.
What the f***, Arturo?
Jack. Kidding. I was fully kidding.
The other day. No, his interview is over. We need to talk about this.
All right, Jack. Tell me how you feel. We did share a beautiful scene. It was nice, but it was in the moment. Look at the camera, not me, because it's making me...
What is he's been snapping for like 10 minutes.
What does this interview become? Please tell us what you think of this project. How do you feel about having written this? Are you proud of your work?
I'm proud of my work. I'm really excited to work on this. This is a story that I've been really I've been waiting to tell for a long time.
Hey, shut the f up. We're ready to
thank
go.
You. Thanks, all right. Alex.
Yeah, so I've actually been exiled and I'm leaving now. Alright, okay. Good luck, guys.
You're going exile.
Yes, yeah, so I was kicked out of my own studio. Alex is running things in there. Hopefully he doesn't f*** things up, okay? What does everyone think after recording scene 1A? Alex?
Huh?
Okay, Bella?
It's magnificent.
Hello, my name is Jack Sherman. I am a freshman in film and TV, and I was asked to participate in this project. I play the interviewer. I would say it went really well. I came in not really knowing what to expect and just seeing the professionalism of the crew, seeing how all the actors that I was working with today were so committed to giving off authentic voice acting performances was really just amazing. I'm just most excited to see how it's gonna actually sound being played and the dynamic between myself and the warden. You know, it's just such an interesting contrast in the voices and I can't wait to see how it's gonna turn out. Thank you for having me.
3, 2, 1.
Hi, I'm Bella Mitchell. Okay, let's redo that.
Hi, I'm Bella Mitchell.
I'm Arturo Gracia.
It was magnificent. I got to watch Arturo fill into Jekyll and Hyde. And it was just a splendid experience that I will never forget.
I think today was just fantastic working around so many really good people at what they do. I mean, Sean giving us the great notes, working off of Bella's work is just incredible. With great talented actress, I can't really put myself down when she's around. I have to pick it up and really do what I must. But overall, just a beautiful.
We set the world on fire.
We set the world on fire.
We set the world on fire. With your help, Sean.
And with your script.
With your guidance. And Alex's support. A rain cloud of suspenseful love.
That was deep as hell. I think a little bit about my character. It's somebody who just really, really honestly cares about things that pertain to him while honestly forgetting what's around him. So somebody who really delves into their passions to the point where those and that around him almost seem to fade into the background. And so it's a very hyper-focused character on getting what he wants and the results that he wants while sadly forgetting his wife.
Okay, well now I need to go into my character description.
Please go ahead.
Okay, well, Mrs. Jekyll cares a lot about her husband, but she also has a heart and life of her own, and she has dreams and aspirations as well, and I think that this is a story of her finding compassion in herself to make room for her husband and for the dreams that she has suppressed for so long.
Hi, I'm Chloe. I'm Lady Beaconsfield.
Hi, I'm Baker Siraj, and I'm playing Dr. Simon Stride.
Yeah, so my character, Lady Beaconsfield, she's a little bit misunderstood. She really cares about what she's doing, but she feels like people are against her, and she has to fight back.
So as the leader of the council that Dr. Jekyll goes to for his experiments, I'm a bit fed up, on a friendly level, fed up with the number of requests and empty promises he grants us. So it's kind of laying down that I'm not mad, I'm disappointed kind of mindset a little bit. Yeah, but we're playing a little bit of good cop, bad cop. A little, I try to defuse a little bit. She tries to, what's the opposite of defuse?
Escalate. Ignite.
Ooh. Escalate, ignite, infuse. Yeah.
Yeah, I thought the energy was up. You know, it was really fun. Our awesome director, Sean, and our sound engineer, Alex, really made...
Slash DJ.
Yeah. Made a welcoming environment for us actors.
It's living in all of us, and it's brought us here.
You are the music in me.
I feel at home, like I want to live in this room. Yeah.
All right, thank you guys so much for your time, and... I can't wait to hear you guys in the mix.
Yeah, so scene three, we have the scene where the doctor is choosing to record all of this data that he's finding and how he's going to perform the experiment on himself. And you get to see a more excited side of the doctor. This is what his life has come to. He's been working towards this. He fought in the court, but now he's realized that he can still fulfill his dream, just with more extreme sides of doing the experiment on himself. So it's kind of like a mixture of that nerve with that excitement. And then we get the introduction of Hyde, which is a whole other thing. This is the younger version of Hyde. We're introduced to the warden at first, which is a different voice, an older version. We have this younger version who's a lot more cocky, a lot more sure of himself. He has now entered the doctor and is gonna...
What did he say? Hey!
And he's gonna just take over his body, and he knows that he's gonna wanna fight it, but eventually he will persist and persevere. So it's that cockiness of the of Hyde and the excitement and nerve of the doctor that I really enjoyed doing.
All right, thank you. Hey guys, it's me. I am on my way to Tish to drop off some equipment, and more importantly, today is the first day in the editing stage of the Jekyll and Hyde project. Hey guys, so this is the director and producer of the Jekyll and Hyde project, Sean Ross here. This is shortly after the first night of editing. We got through scene 1A and 1B today. And I just thought now would be a good time to go over some of the unseen parts of the editing process, which I would consider the editing pre-production. So right up here, actually, I'll have screenshots of a floor plan that I made. And you may be wondering, why did you make a floor plan if there are no visuals to this? Actually, when you listen to the mix, if you have the privilege to listen to it with headphones or with some sort of stereo system, there is actually a lot of spatial and 3D audio at work that you're actually listening to. And that is partially thanks to the floor plan, which makes it a lot easier. So as you can see on the right hand, it's set up pretty much like a graph. On the left, or on the right, no, it's left to the right, but I'll like add a something. On the one side, we have a graph, pretty much line going up, and that is going from 100% to 0%, and blah, 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 right? And then we have our panning, which is what we hear from our left to our right, going from negative 100 to 0 to 100. And this basically helps us precisely chart out where we want our characters to move around the scene, where we want certain sound effects to come from. And I think it just helped us save a lot of time in the editing process. And I just want to talk about it quickly. So I will flash on the screen. So this is scene 1A, the asylum building. And here, this is scene 1B, which is the courtroom after the transition. And then here is the floor plan of scene 2, the kitchen scene. And then here is the floor plan of scene 3, which takes place in the laboratory. Alright, right now Alex and I are in the recording studio, just creating some sounds for the J&H project, doing some footstep work with the different sound effects and, you know.
Tell the guards to open up the gate.
What? It's a big...
Hi, I'm Alex, and I am the mixer editor for Jekyll and Hyde, Sean's Jekyll and Hyde. Favorite part of the whole project, probably working with Sean, Art, my friends, and all the other actors that are not here today. Just being in the room together, having a good time. That's what we're here to do. So.
What would you say was one of the challenges or difficulties you faced?
Oh, Sean and I. So during scene two, when I was editing scene two, I accidentally overwrote the parent files and added a reverb onto it, essentially rendering all of the parent files useless. So in essentially every single thing related to that file was completely overwritten with the audio suite. So we had to really work around that. We had to stitch and edit together pieces from other different takes because there were some problems here and there, but we had no other choice. And just making that decision to either, like making that decision, going through that struggle was probably the hardest. But other than that, honestly, just the time it takes to edit all this, just the little tiny details that you can hear, things like that, probably the hardest. Yo, put some respect on sound, man. Like, I was on set today as a mixer. Oh man, I was like, can I please get another take just for audio? He said, no, you have 20 minutes to set up lights. Okay. Oh, the directors, y'all think you're the boss? I'm just not gonna record. How about that? I'm just not gonna speed. How about that? Yeah, f*** y'all. Bye-bye.
Hey guys, director and producer Sean Ross here. Thank you so much for watching 15 minutes of us just completely fumbling around and making this project. We had so much fun making the project and so happy that you guys wanted to watch the behind the scenes of this. So if you're here at the end and you stuck with it all the way, down in the comment section, let me know what you guys thought. And if you had a chance to watch the actual Jekyll and Hyde project, let me know what you thought of that as well. All right, again, thank you guys so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next behind the scenes.